Consider this a preview of what's going to happen in November of this year. Yeah, I already started to make my schedule for 2018 to 2019. I'm always that early. But then again, I'm always doing stuff way earlier. Anyway, what can I say about that, Sir Raven? The only Disney sitcom that actually knows what to do, a Disney sitcom. Unlike the other Disney sitcoms, well, it just tries way too hard to be funny, but the magic is just taking over Disney Channel. In other words, there's always a lot of teen sitcoms on Disney Channel, and there's always less and less cartoons on it. This show knows what it's doing to make us laugh. Now, here's two reasons why I want to review a That's So Raven episode, which is not part of my schedule for this time. One, it's still Black History Month. And two, like I said, the preview of what's going to happen in November. In November, I'm going to be reviewing That's So Raven and Hannah Montana episodes. I'll get into more detail on that when I finish my schedule for next year. But for right now, let's review not only the best episode from the show, at least from my view, but the most important episode of the show, True Colors. Raven and Chelsea want to work out a job at Sassy's, so they go to the boss of the store, Chloe. After Raven and Chelsea did the tax, Chloe will review the applications and she will get back to Raven and Chelsea tomorrow. Now, Raven was the better out of the two. Chelsea, in this show, they made her dumb, but also a very good heart. All I can say is that she's a better character than most of the other characters that we got from the other Disney sitcoms. You're gonna have to wait until I get to my schedule for next year, because I have a lot to explain. Anyway, when Chelsea got a phone call from Chloe, she got the job, but Raven didn't. Because Raven just had a vision, and then she completely heard that Chloe doesn't hire black people. Discrimination is a very strong and important word in this episode. And what do I have to say about this episode so far? Like I said, discrimination is something that they're showing in this episode, because it's not the right thing to do. The fact that Raven worked really hard to get a job at Sassy's and she didn't because she was black is just so wrong. It just shows that Chloe doesn't know anything about Raven's talents whatsoever. This is one of the reasons why people who worked really hard but don't get the job all because of one thing that doesn't involve their talents is considered discrimination. Raven has an idea that Chloe didn't say, "I don't hire black people," in front of Raven. It could be something else. So, she calls Chelsea before she quits her job. In order to expose Chloe's secrets of not hiring black people, Miss Johnson wants Chelsea to wear a hat that has a camel on it. And as for Raven, is wearing which could possibly be her best disguise ever. Seriously. It's really hard to see Raven in this disguise. I mean, the bald head, the mustache, and the glasses, and even the suit that she's wearing. It looks so brilliant. And the jokes that they deliver when she wears this disguise is just amazing. However, during the next minutes of this episode, they couldn't able to crack the code from Chloe because she's, of course, hiding her secret. She's pretending to be nice and saying that she does respect Black History Month, that she wishes there was Black History Month every single month. I'm not making this up. Her line is so brilliant. And that's what makes this episode way better, is because she's trying her best to hide her secret. But that didn't last long. Since Chloe trusts Chelsea, she completely exposes her secret. And for the final minutes of this episode, Chloe has been fired from Sassy's. Thanks to Raven, Eddie, and Chelsea by doing the right thing for a stand-up. And the episode ends with all the characters eating their food for Black History Month. This episode is a very important episode. Before any of you ask, I didn't grow up watching That's So Raven because It came out in 2003, and I was way too long to be interested into watching Disney Channel shows. I mostly grew up with Nickelodeon Cartoon Network. But anyways, the only episodes that I remember from this show is Vision Impossible and When There Is Smoke. Those are the only episodes that I kind of like from That's So Raven. I just couldn't get into the characters. But at the end of last year, since I wanted to review more live-action material, I decided that I wanted to look at Disney Channel sitcoms. And of course, the one that made the Disney Channel sitcom popular, yes, I know, Lizzie McGuire started, but I did say popular, was That's So Raven. Now back to this episode. It has a setup and always has a wrap-up at the end of this episode, just like in every other episode from this show. It knows how to end it perfectly, unlike other shows that did in the future after this. When Raven gets a job, and when she doesn't get it, it's because she's black, it's very important to know that people like Chloe deserves to be fired and deserves to teach a lesson to not judge people on how they look. And this is the second time that they do it. First being That's So Not Raven. Now I did say that That's So Raven is also funny. And this episode is funny, but not completely funny. Because trust me, this episode is trying its hardest to be very serious about black people. And if you try to make this way too funny, it probably won't make this episode really important. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you. I didn't laugh a lot at most of the jokes in this episode. I did laugh at the jokes while Raven was wearing the disguise, but other than that, everything else is just meh, from my view. Yes, I can understand it's a different type of humor from a different type of company, but still. But there are some jokes that I do like in this show. There's also a subplot where Corey has to write a report about Black History Month. And he really doesn't care about Black History Month because he just wants to do things his way, obviously. However, when he falls asleep during his project, he gets a dream about black people from the past. And in my opinion, this subplot is just basically what it is. Being like the main plot, but adding more information about black people. True Colors really wants to teach kids that black people are very important. Now, I'm not a fan of black people, to be honest, but I at least respect them for what they do. What this episode shows kids is to show that black people want some respect as well, just like everyone else in this entire planet. And trust me when I say this, you really need kids to watch this episode. And this is not a suggestion. This is an important warning, because people need to learn on to never discriminate people that are black. Because this episode really shows that you should always do the right thing, even if you don't like black people. Now, I am aware that people do have problems with black people, especially the nice ones. However, you always need to be nice to them, because trust me, you will probably get yourself a lot of trouble if someone who is just trying to expose your secrets out in the world, you really know that they're just doing the right thing, and what you're doing is the wrong thing. And I can really say what they're trying to do in this episode. Not trying way too hard to be funny, but also be very serious with life lessons. That's So Raven does a lot of life lessons over the past couple of seasons. From season 1 through season 4, they teach his kids that there's some other ways that people have disabilities, but there is some elements that make them very helpful. Raven is completely helpful in this episode by not only completely exposing the secrets from Chloe, but also being a very great walker as well. And by the way, if you completely bring up the fact that she doesn't learn anything from this episode because, yeah, I did check the news about her not hiring someone, but that's a completely different story. I just think that it's probably a misunderstanding, in my opinion. I just don't keep up with a lot of things. Don't judge me. But anyways, this episode is a very important episode that everyone, even people who are a fan of this show, should watch it. I give this episode a 10 out of 10. episodes like Josh is done from Drake and Josh, and this episode deserves this perfect weighing on taking itself seriously and not only being emotional, but also showing life lessons to the kids. I'm Lonely Fanboy Foyhio, and I'll see you next time. And celebrate Black History Month.